So we start thinking that, oh, okay, the subtle body itself is me. Subtle body itself is also not you. Okay? A person who has a gross body, a very strong body, but is not able to see because eyes are operating, the sense organs are not operating. Okay? Subtle body is not able to operate and use the sense organs. Right? So then our ancestors or rishis said, the subtle body is also his vehicle. Subtle body is also instrument. Just like a physical body is instrument, subtle body is also instrument. The sense organs are operated by devatas, they said. Okay, devatas, we have to bring in a concept of devatas. Many people,
hello Bhoto,
many people in India, okay, are in India, we worship so many devatas. We say 33 crore devatas, right? And the Westerners or other religions, they are confused with our concept. So many gods. What Indians themselves don't know is that there are no so many gods. There is only one God, Brahman. Okay? Supreme reality. Only one God, Brahman. There is no other God. Then, for the Brahman, there are infinite powers. Each power of God, each power of Brahman is called a Devata, not God. Devata is not God. Devata is wrongly translated in English as God. Devata means light. Light is consciousness, a power of consciousness. One infinite God called Brahman has infinite powers. And each of the power becomes a Devata for us. We worship one Devata. We don't worship that Devata. We worship one power of infinite Brahman. Understand? To give an example, the fire, okay, what are the qualities of fire? Light, burning, okay, heat. So these are the qualities of fire. Now if you consider fire as God, three devatas are heat, light. You understand? So devata means not, devata means power of God. It's not God himself. This is called Shakti. Devata, Shakti. Okay. Always, all of us worship only one God called Brahman. For worshipping one God of Brahman, we may approach through one power of God. Okay. Because human mind cannot think of the infinity. So we approach that infinity through finite, limited power. Okay? So devatas are the powers. Now, why devatas are brought in here? Because the eyes cannot see, because your sense organs, subtle sense organs are not able to see. The subtle sense organs themselves are not able to see because they are the just instrument. The consciousness or power of Brahman operates through them to make them see. The consciousness is required to see. The consciousness is called Devata because it's light. It's not a physical light. It's a non-physical light. Okay? To give an example, if I have to see the sun, I need eyes. Okay? Sunlight, if I have to see, I need eyes. So eyes are the light for the sun. That means my consciousness is the light for the sun. It's greater than light than sun, light of the sun. Are you understanding? If you are not conscious, then you cannot see the sun. That means you are able to light up the sun because of your eyes. Right? What is the point of having a sun if you are not able to see? That means your ability to see is much greater power than the sun. So the ability to see to your eyes comes from the consciousness. That consciousness is called Devata, the power of consciousness. Okay? So each sense organ, they have mentioned a power of consciousness, Devata.
How can there be 33 crore?
Different powers.
Oh, other than human body.
Oh, no, infinite powers. There are so many powers. Okay. So the power of consciousness is called Devata. This power of eye, power of ears. Okay. Power of ears is called Dig Devata. Because ears can work only if there is a space. The space consciousness is called Dig Devata. The consciousness of the space is called Dig Devata. I can be aware of space only if the consciousness of space is there. That consciousness is called Dig Devata. Because ears can hear sound. Sound you can hear only in this space. Sound travels in space. Okay. Dig Devata. Then eyes is called Surya Devata. The power of consciousness is called to the eyes. The Surya Devata is giving power to the eyes. Surya Devata, what you see, Surya Sun, what we see there, okay, is giving sunlight. But the sunlight cannot be seen unless Surya Devata within our eyes is able to cooperate. See.
Oh, the same sun is the Devata here also.
No. The sun, eyes can work in light, presence of light, right? The consciousness which is able to recognize light is called Surya Devata. Okay. If Surya Devata doesn't operate, your eyes will not operate, then you cannot see the sunlight or you cannot see anything. That's why many people who have, when their eye disease is there, they pray to Aditya Hradayam, the prayer for sun. For the nose, it's called Ashwini Devata. Ashwini is the fins. For the nose is a sense of smell. Okay, the sense of smell is controlled by a consciousness called Ashwini Devata. Ashwini Kumaras. Skin is called Vayu Devata. What is the experience of skin? Skin is touch.
Sensation.
Sensation, touch. Okay, the touch, the experience of touch is recognized by or cognized by Vayu Devata. When we say Vayu Devata, consciousness, a power of consciousness. Okay. So these devatas are working for, not for you as an individual, jiva. They are working for Brahman, consciousness. All devatas work for Brahman. The jiva is just a vehicle. Okay. The subtle body is just a vehicle through which these devatas operate. Now there is a concept of devata also is made clear here. The reason is simple. You start asking, okay, if I have a subtle body, I can see. She can see. The animal can see. Right? The seeing is there in everybody. Is seeing individual or universal? That universal, because from the universal consciousness called Brahman, these powers are coming. Not because of your subtle body. It's not a power of the subtle body. That's a universal power which operates through each of the animal. That's why each of the animal is able to see. Surya Devata is operating, the consciousness of sun is operating through all the animals' eyes. That's why all the animals are able to see something. Okay, if the instrument is bad, in the sense subtle body, some damage has happened to the prana or something, even the Surya Devata's presence can't see that because the vehicle is not there. Right? Please understand, we were trying to discuss individual called who am I? We are not the body, I am a subtle body. Then you start thinking I am subtle body. Okay. The subtle body itself is being functioning because of the power of consciousness called Brahman. This power of consciousness called Devatas. And it's not individual to you. All through all the bodies it's operating. That's why all of them are able to see, hear, touch, feel. Because so that Devatas are operating. Devatas are universal forces. Right? Universal powers of consciousness. You can imagine devatas. If Brahman is the prime minister, Brahman is the prime, or Brahman is the president. Okay, Brahman doesn't do anything. So, Brahman is the president. Devatas are like IAS officers. They'll keep on doing some functions. But they are not doing for individually for you. They are doing for universally for all of you. So this is the function of the subtle body. Is this clear? Why devatas are called light? Because they are the light of consciousness, the awareness. They are not physical light. Right? See, scientists can see only the physical. Scientists cannot see the non-physical. Okay? Suppose you go to a scientist, say, I have pain. Okay? Will scientist be able to find out how much pain is there? Because pain is not physical. Pain appears in the physical. Pain appears in the physical body, but the experience of pain itself is not physical. It's a consciousness. How will you measure? The scientist can put some instruments. He can measure the electricity, voltage, which is associated with the body. He cannot say how much pain is there. Right? Your feelings, your emotions, all these are non-physical. They cannot be measured. Which scientific instrument can measure love? It can measure a gift. Oh, 5,000 rupees worth, 10,000 worth of gift because of love. A golden ring is given. Love. But that's all objects. Can love be measured? Can emotions, feelings be measured?
So you're saying if a cut happens here, pain is not here.
Yeah. So this is, I already told, you know. If something happens in the physical body, it's not the physical body which experiences, subtle body which experiences.
That joy and happiness you said. Physical pain is not for the body.
Physical pain appears in the body because subtle body is experiencing the pain. Experiencer is the subtle body. Subtle body is the experiencer because of devatas present in the subtle body.
But it's pain also, sir. Different stages are there. No, we can feel it. Now it is less or less.
Now you can feel it, but the instruments cannot measure it. The scientific instruments cannot measure the consciousness because they are not physical. Suppose there is a leg pain. Okay, you say, I have pain. Go to the doctor, he'll say, how much pain, more pain, less pain, he'll say. But that you only can feel. The doctor cannot feel. Any instrument is there to measure the pain? There's no instrument. Because the pain is not physical. Subtle body is not easily available for scientific instruments. That's what I'm trying to say.
Mm-hmm.
Understand? Right. They can measure the ECG. EEG. You can put a probe to the brain and say, brain is functioning or not. Brain is functioning when the thoughts are coming. But thoughts itself you cannot find out. Thoughts are subtle. The effect of the subtle body and the gross body you can find out. But gross, subtle body itself you cannot find out. Scientific instruments cannot find out. Understand?
You can't make out the thoughts.
You cannot make out. So that thought, they are all subtle. Thoughts, feelings, emotions. You can see the effect of that. Oh, somebody got angry. Okay, his face becomes red and all. There is effect on the physical body you can see. But subtle body what's happening you cannot find out. Right? So that subtle body is because of the consciousness operating through subtle body. Consciousness comes from Brahman, doesn't belong to subtle body. Right? Now tell me, who are you? Are you the subtle body which is changing feelings, emotions? Or prana. Prana means running the physiological functions. Digestion, you know, digestion, excretion, breathing and all. Are you the subtle body? Or are you the subtle body sense organs? Are you the mind? Mind consists of four functions. Manas, buddhi, ahankara, chitta, which is constantly changing. Is it satya or mithya mind? Real or unreal? Mind is unreal because it's constantly changing. Okay, is the mind experiencer or experienced?
Experiencer.
See, mind is the experiencer of the gross body. Right? The mind is the experiencer of the gross body. So the gross body is the experienced. Right? For example, when I say I eat apple, Apple is experienced and the experiencer. Right? Experienced and experiencer are different. They cannot be same. Okay? Apple is not me. But I am the experiencer. Now when you say here I am, you are referring to the body. Body is the experiencer and apple is experienced. Right? So because we brought in the concept of subtle body, now the gross body is experienced. Subtle body is the experiencer. Correct? Subtle body is the experiencer. Correct? So we are actually trying to find out me, real me. Experiencer is me, experienced is not me. That's why subtle body drops a gross body and goes to another body after death. Body is the experienced, I am the experiencer, which is subtle body. Now is subtle body experiencer? Is the question. Okay? Is there somebody who is more a different experiencer? Do you know there's do you know that there are doubts in the mind?
Thoughts in the mind.
I have thoughts in the mind, I don't have thoughts in the mind. Right? So that means you are the knower of the experience. Okay? The body, the subtle body, there is experience of thoughts, feelings, emotions, all those experiences are going on. Who knows it? I know it. The I is separate from the subtle body also. Subtle body is an object and I am the knower of the subtle body, different from me, different from the subtle body. If you don't distinguish this, then you start thinking, oh, I am the mind, I am the subtle body. Practically you are saying, I am the subtle body. I am happy, I am unhappy, okay, I am sad, I am joyful. You'll say, you associate the subtle body and says, I am this. Really, if you look at closely, you are not that. That's also experience and you are the seer of the experience. You are knower of the experience. You are the one guy who says, I am happy and I am unhappy. How can we say both same? So you should be something different from the both. And that different from the both is knower of happiness and unhappiness. Okay? So I am not even the subtle body. Right?